lights on, fading. This is not a smooth process. Hello.
Hello.
Hold on. Okay, doing the swaps.
No problem. Hey, Jamie.
Hey, Jamie.
How's it going?
Good.
I like. That was just not as funny as we thought it would be.
Yeah, you're right. All right. Check the stream. Yeah, we're checking the stream. Okay, there's no laughter at it. All right, that's fine. This whole stream was, it exists exclusively for us to make that joke because we share the name.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, that's it, Jamie. Mm-hmm. It's James and Friends. That's close, yeah.
Yeah, so it's the Jamie stream, and we're going to show Oxygen Not Included playing for the first time.
Yeah.
It's going to be a PAX tomorrow as well, but we thought we'd give it a little preview right now. You guys are going to see what we're showing at the demo, except actually even more, because I'm going to turn off the timer at the demo. It's a 15-minute timer. I'm just going to turn it off and just kind of walk everyone through it. Yeah. And
Sweet.
We'll just play through the game, right?
Let's check and see. Is anybody going to be at PAX tomorrow to play the demo? There's a bit of a delay, so we'll wait a bit to see.
Nice, what a
answers.
Nice beard! I agree.
Hey,
my beard is really nice. it's really.
Yeah, you're right. I was thinking that.
This is like
as soon as you walked in, I was like, "Ooh, that beard
this
is."
It's like
just,
a weeks of growth.
Yeah.
You know. Yeah. So.
This is. I shaved this morning. So,
yeah, it's just right there.
I just sneezed and it was like, "Ooh."
We just have reverse. Mine grows on top. Yours grows on the bottom.
Yeah,
that's
really
how it works.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. For sure.
Mm-hmm. Sorry, Mitchie. Oxygen's not included.
There it is.
Boom. It's mic drop.
It's like what's the amount of time from start of stream when that joke is,
is
addressed?
There it is, yeah.
It was a minute and a half, so it's pretty good.
So I was telling Jamie the last time I did this stream, I'm pretty sure I was doing Time Attack Invisible Ink Expert Plus, and it was just like this incredibly stressful experience because I had 30 seconds per turn, and at the same time, James was heckling me throughout the whole thing. And I was just trying to survive. So this time should be much more relaxed because you can actually pause the game and we can talk about it. So
and I'll heckle you about half as often as he heckled.
I'm really looking forward to that.
Yeah.
So do we want to just answer some questions? Want to turn on the sound for that? What do we think?
Yeah. Do you want to answer some questions first off?
I don't know if there's questions going on. We can answer them as it goes.
Yeah. Yeah. I'll keep an eye out. So if you guys have any questions, please feel free to ask them. I'll keep an eye on the stream, and we've got a couple Klei folks as well in the chat that will be forwarding questions to us if we miss them. So if we don't answer it, just keep asking and we'll get to it eventually.
Great.
Shall we?
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay. And there, and there.
Boom.
And.
Oh, what's going on? Oh, there.
There. There we go. Take it away.
So here we go. For those who don't know, Oxygen Not Included is a management simulation game. We're basically simulating as much as we can. We like to say we're simulating everything. But you'll see exactly how much we're doing here. So I'm going to start the demo. Just let me know what questions there are.
Yeah.
Will it have aliens? Yes, there are aliens. Left, Jamie, what's your job?
Am I on the left here?
I don't know.
Yes, I think I'm on the left.
Yeah, okay.
I'm working on sound for Oxygen Not Included.
Yeah.
Doing audio. Oh, that's my mom right there.
Seriously?
Hi. Yeah. Hi from Mexico, Jamie B. Hi, Mom.
Aw, she's
so cute.
Kiss.
Everybody's coming out.
Okay, so I'm selecting my duplicants here. Basically, all your colonists are clones of previous people in the past, and there's a little backstory for each one. They have different stats going in, and they also have different traits. So if you look at this guy, this Linus is destructive. She takes her frustration out. So when she gets stressed out, she'll break your machines and things like that. So I'm going to pick her, of course.
Nice
That's
choice.
Exactly what's going on.
Relatable duplicate.
Yeah, relatable. That's what I do. And then around the office, I just kick stuff around.
You have a couple computers laying around just in case you need to destroy something.
There's a +3 learning. Okay. That's good for research. I need someone who does some digging. This one's a little bit good at digging, and maybe someone that's good at running and cooking here.
Mm.
Right?
Yeah.
There we go. Oh, we got a all-girl crew. Let's do it.
Hell yeah.
Yep.
We got a question, Topanka. Mm-hmm. When can we throw money at you guys?
When it's ready.
There you go.
It should be in a few months, so I don't know if that means this year or not, but we'd like to go into early access in a few months. It's getting there. Okay, so here we go. I spent a long time on that intro.
It looks really good. Thanks. I'm very happy with it.
Okay. Welcome. This is a 15-minute taste. Yeah, right? No, it's not.
Not today, chumps.
Boom. No more 15 minutes.
Okay. Is that command in the PAX build?
It is.
Okay. I didn't say what the command was.
Not. All right. Okay, so here we are. Look around here. I can pause the time. I can speed it up. There's the buttons here. I can speed it up. It's already at medium speed. I'm going to... So you don't control the duplicates directly. You kind of tell them what you want done, and then they'll go and do it. The closest people will go do it. So I can press dig here. And I'm going to dig... What am I going to dig for? I'm going to dig for some metal. There's some metal there, and there's some metal down here. So let's go for the ones down there. Okay, I'm just going to go dig here. And... There's a little bit of oxylite. Is there questions going on? What's going on?
Just people talking about the command.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Yeah, the secret command.
The secret command, that's right. You ruined it.
It is going to be taken out of the stream, or out of the PAX demo, everybody.
Uh-huh. All right, so I'm going to dig through there. They can only navigate two tiles, so here I actually need to build. I'm going to start building stuff. I'm going to build a ladder here, because otherwise it gets stuck down there. Okay, so, I got some metal. I'm gonna plan some ladders, and now they're building the ladders up so that they can dig back up. Let's just pause for a sec here. Okay, I got some water here. I got all sorts of things. Let's take a look. We got sand, we got some sandstone, we got some algae, got some water here. So I really want the water. I also need a better oxygen source.
Where are you getting oxygen from right now?
So this stuff here, this is oxylite. What it does is if you click it, it's... that state is gas. Huh, that's a bug. it's state is solid.
It's emitting gas.
Yeah, it's emitting oxygen right now. And basically it sublimates into... So it turns itself into oxygen over time. It
kind of
lets itself out. And... you can even go into the details and take a look at how much mass, the specific heat capacity. So if you're really nerdy, you can really look into all that. And everything's transferring energy into everything else, the heat map. So you can take a look at the heat map. This is the heat map that's going on. You can see it's just slightly warmer here. It's getting cooler. You can go look out.
Whoa.
Oh, there's some really warm stuff over here.
Getting sizzling over there.
Yeah. And so that's 34 degrees. You can change it to Fahrenheit if you're American. Or you can change it to Kelvin if you're super nerdy.
Elia loves the Kelvin.
The Kelvin, yeah, that's right. That's
but when I first started playing the game, I was playing with Kelvin, and I was like, I
have no idea.
Is 6,000 Kelvin hot? I guess so.
You subtract, obviously, by 273.15.
Yeah, of course.
That's the obvious number that you want to do.
How could you not understand
this? Yeah, exactly.
This?
Okay, so here we go.
Sorry, Elia.
Sorry. Yeah.
Just right. Cheesing Elia.
Dig this through. Okay, I want some oxygen though, because this stuff's gonna melt, gonna disappear at some point. So I need my own. I had to build. What am I gonna build here? Oxygen here. I can build an algae habitat, and it consumes the carbon dioxide. Oh yeah. So if you look at oxygen, you can see this oxygen's going on. It's quite a bit of oxygen, but also this red.
Mm.
That's the carbon dioxide. So when your duplicates breathe. They breathe in the oxygen and then they exhale the carbon dioxide. You can see that the carbon dioxide's falling because it's heavier than the oxygen.
So you'll get pits of carbon dioxide if you're not careful.
Yep. Some people have asked if there's going to be multiplayer. Nope, there's no multiplayer in this game. It is single player. So that's where it is right now. Okay, so here we go. I'm going to build a mineral deoxidizer. Which is very scientific. It crushes rocks and then squeezes out the oxygen out of it. That's exactly how it works in real life.
I was going to ask, is there like any real life analog? Is this based off of any like...
Well, you know, it's oxidized rock, right? Mm-hmm. So there is oxygen in it.
Yeah.
And, you know, they just kind of squeeze it out.
Yeah.
They squeeze it out. Right. Okay, so I'm going to build that and off they go. I need to keep digging as well. Come on, keep going. Digging and digging. So this really is a space nerd simulator. That's exactly what it is. Yep, it is a space nerd simulator.
Correct,
in fact,
yeah.
If you take a look at these dupes, you can see that they've got calories and they're burning their calories as well. So you got to feed them. And if they're too cold, they'll actually burn more calories in order to warm themselves up.
Ah.
And it's also based on their specific heat capacity, which we modeled as water. And so that's exactly it. It's using real numbers on how to do that.
I didn't know that.
Yeah,
that's awesome.
And they want their body temperature to be 37 degrees, just like we do.
Nice.
Mm-hmm. All right, so we build this, and you can see that it says no wire connected, so we need to power it. So I'm going to build a power. The fun thing is that you don't really have to get into the nitty-gritty of all that. It's just there.
Yeah.
And it's simulating in the background. Yeah. And if you really want to know, you can go look.
Yeah.
But you know, when you're playing it, you don't really have to think about it too much unless you really want to get into the
it. Because I've played this game quite a bit. And
you haven't seen that yet.
And like a lot of the stuff in the info panel, it's there sometimes if I'm like, oh, I wonder like when will this melt
or when does
this change states. It's there if you want, but I never feel bogged down by it.
So everything is like that. So if you look at the water, you can actually see what the freezing point is and what the evaporation point is. So it will change into ice or steam, depending on how hot it is as well. And that's true for everything. I mean, there's some crazy stuff like even the oxygen can turn into liquid, right? But your duplicates are going to die long before that.
They're just trying to breathe this.
Yeah, that's right.
It hurts. Hey, thanks, Soundango. Said, love that drag sound.
I know, right? Everybody loves that sound.
I'm very happy
about
that.
It's really good. It's really, really good.
Thank you.
And you're doing it a lot, so. Okay, so it's eating time to go and eat. You start with some rations. So you can see we have 15 kcal here. And thanks a lot. and so we're going to need our own food at some point as well, because that's just what we start with.
I got a couple questions. Will color schemes be available to be changed for those who can't see certain colors?
Yeah, we should be able to build that. I don't know if it's going to be in day one in the early access or not. We did do something similar for Oxygen Not Included, actually. Mm. We have a colorblind mode, and we have three different
for
modes.
Invisible?
For invisible. Okay. You can actually change the different ones.
Nice.
So it is pretty, yeah. But also, everything is, you can mouse over and see what everything's going on, so it's pretty good that way. I'm just going to close these tips as well.
If one does not have a PhD in physics and or chemistry, will the game still be playable?
Absolutely. Yeah. So, okay, it's nighttime right now, so everyone's sleeping. It's really quite intuitive because it is using real numbers in as much as we can. Well, of course, we have to compress the time, otherwise a day will literally take 24 hours.
Yeah.
So you can play it while just kind of intuiting a lot of the elements of the game. I won't really need to be referring to like the nitty gritty as I'm playing right now.
Yeah.
So
I like that. See that. The whole simulation is happening there, kind of underneath the hood, and if you want to get in and understand all that simulation, that will help you play the game. Whereas if you just play it, you're still very able to play it.
Right. That's right. So you see that when they all went to bed, this machine turned off. So if we pause the game for a bit, we can look at the daily reports. And yesterday, we were using a bunch of energy, but we didn't remove as much as we added. And so the rest of it went to waste. The wasted thing should say it wasted. There's a bug there.
Yeah.
But that's okay. So what's going on is Bay was running on this manual generator, and it's working on this deoxidizer, and then there's a whole bunch of the energy that's just wasted. It's just going away.
Right.
So in order for us to not waste it and also have it run during the night, we need to build a little battery. So I'm going to build a battery here.
Do you store the dirt after digging it up?
You can store the dirt. Oh no, they all need to go to the rush. I forgot to build a toilet.
Oh, gee.
Okay.
Novice mistake.
Okay, so I'm going to deal with this first. So they all have a bladder and they all need to go to the toilet. And if they don't, they're going to make a mess. All right, so I got to, come on. Okay, this
which is actually outhouse. Relatable. Somebody said, I hope they don't fall asleep in hazardous items.
Yes,
they can
right.
fall asleep in hazardous items, for sure.
They can, indeed. So hurry up and build that so everyone can go pee.
I always like this moment where it's like a race against the clock.
Yeah.
Because you have the little progress bar.
Oh, my God.
They all need to pee.
Oh, my God. What was the other question you asked me before they all needed to go pee?
Do they do you store dirt after digging?
Oh, that's right. So you can. You don't have to. They just go and pick it up off the floor. But if you want to, like, store it somewhere specific so that it's closer or something like that, then you can. Okay, this one. Okay, next person. Come on.
Are they all three going to be able to make it?
Come on. Hopefully.
Uriah, come on. Come on, buddy. Stop eating. Get
just
in there.
Go.
There we go.
Oh, there we go. Okay.
Right. Sweet.
Okay.
Crisis averted.
Yes. Okay, let's keep going. I need to build some food.
I love that that's the first major crisis you've encountered in this game.
Who designed this thing?
What do you do in this game? Well, let me tell you.
You go relieve yourself. That's my nice wording for it. Okay, how's my... This is my carbon dioxide. I've got some power grid going on. I have temperature.
Ooh, heating up in there.
Okay, it's because the battery's hot and the mineral deoxidizer's hot. There's no rooms. We have no rooms for anyone. We have no place for anyone to sleep right now, so they just sleep on the floor.
Not very comfortable. They won't be very happy about that.
Nope. Oh, actually, my stress seems to be rising. Oh. So let's take a look at the stress here. This person. Basically, I need to start assigning some beds is really what's going on here before they go. Okay, let's do that. Let's go and build some beds for everyone.
Dexter's Comic Laboratory has a question. Hold up. Do they take in more oxygen during sleep?
Currently, no, but that's a pretty good idea.
Yeah, I like that.
It's actually good.
Taking in deep sleep.
They do have different traits, so different duplicants will breathe more. Not in this current build, but the one that we're currently working on, the development one, they have the different traits, so some will definitely, they want to eat more, want to breathe more, that sort of thing.
Yeah.
Will there be early access? Yes, the answer is there is going to be early access. Okay. Can we prioritize the actions? Yes, there's several ways to prioritize. So I'll show you the first way. Actually, I already built the... Okay, I'm just going to plan some stuff out first. So I can build a micro musher, which squeezes the microbes out of the dirt.
I love how many things are just squeezing things
out of
other things. Yeah,
that's right. Squeeze things. Okay, and so I'm going to plan that out. Okay. And let's say that I want somebody to do the building. Well, actually, building is already high priority in general, so you can see this. This is the jobs list, and everybody does everything right now. Mm-hmm. And what I can do is I can get people, I can sort by, for example, digger, and I can say nobody else dig, and also except Uriah, you only dig. That's what happens.
Right.
Right? And now Uriah will go and dig.
Because they have different skill levels in certain things. Some people are better diggers. You might want to assign them to only digging to maximum efficiency.
Yep. Okay, so I need to queue up some mush bars. So this is like tier zero food.
Yeah.
Mush bars. The thing about mush bars, though, is that if you eat them, you might get sick because they're really gross.
Yeah, they're pretty gross.
So I'm just going to... you can queue up one by one, or you can... say I'm just going to queue it infinitely. And it's saying it doesn't have enough resources, but they got to go pick it up, that's why, and then,
there you go.
And then it'll work. Okay, come on. There you go. Off they go. And
I worked on the sound effect for eating mush bars yesterday.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, it was a disgusting day.
Yummy.
Yeah.
It was yummy.
Because I actually had to eat gross things.
Oh, really? Seriously? Oh, no.
That's why I was working at home.
Did you, like, pick up some Soylent and off you go?
Is Soylent actually gross like that?
I don't know.
I've never had it.
I think it's like juice, kind of like a mush juice, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah. What did you eat?
I overcooked hard-boiled eggs. And to get a nice chunky sound, you have to eat the entire thing.
Oh.
So, yeah, it was good.
I'm so sorry.
That's all right. My entire house smells like eggs now.
Oh, my goodness.
It's excellent.
Okay. Oh, okay. So I need to... I have a CO2 problem going on here. Everyone's going to go to bed.
Oh, using their beds now.
Using their beds, except this...
Uriah's just up late.
She's having a midnight snack.
Snack, yeah.
And off she goes to bed. So I have a CO2 problem, so I got to...
Let's see that CO2 problem.
There we go.
CO2
problem right going
Taking
on here.
Up. Yeah.
So I'm going to build some algae habitats. which can eat up some of the CO2 here.
We had a question, how do you clean up the clutter on the ground?
So you can create storage regions or storage lockers and then move them, and they'll automatically move them. So let's look at the base. There's the storage compactor here. Mm. But first, I need research to do that. Yeah. So I'm going to get some research done. So let's get some research here. Where should I put the research? Let's go dig this out. I really need a compost, too.
Mm-hmm.
You want to recycle everything. You know, if you've watched The Martian, he uses everyone else's
potatoes, et cetera.
Yeah, so you got to do that kind of thing, because otherwise you're just wasting stuff as it goes along. Like this water's going to run out. Although I do have quite a bit of water in this generation, which is nice. Oh, this is a different biome over here. This is another biome. That's why it's really warm over there. It's like,
Got a question. What happens to sound effects when you speed up time? Everything has it's a pitch parameter, so things are pitched up when things go faster, and they're also turned down a little bit so that you don't just have like really loud, really fast stuff happening.
Also, we have things where when you zoom out, it shuts off some of them and things like that, right?
Yeah, it stops playing some stuff, turns down some stuff.
Okay, so I don't have a place to put my research station right now. I just don't know where I want to put it. Where do you think I should put it? Maybe here?
Where makes a good research spot for you?
Just somewhere accessible and someplace that has enough oxygen, usually, right? So I think this place is okay.
Looks pretty good.
Just do that here, although it might get really hot over there. Yeah, it's really hot. Actually, let's get rid of that. Okay, let's put it just slightly away. Yeah. There we go.
How big is the world?
I think this place that I'm looking at is like 5%, maybe.
Right. Lots of different biomes.
Yeah, there's lots of different biomes. It goes on for quite a while.
Yeah.
And frankly, I've never built a base that was even close to.
Yeah, nor have I.
Never even close.
Even getting into a different biome.
Yeah.
I'm usually getting to the point where I'm just getting into a different biome.
Yeah, that's right. Okay, so I dug this out. I would like to get a compost going, though. That means someone really going to prioritize that. Come on, someone go do it. Why isn't your eye? Oh, because I told her not to do anything but dig. There you go. Okay, go. We'll do that stuff right now.
Zilver asks, can you reach the surface of the asteroid?
Yes, but there's no atmosphere up there, so it's not going to be very friendly for you.
That makes sense.
Basically, all your gases just dissipate. The water falls out and all sorts of bad things happen.
Do duplicants fall out?
Not right now. There is some gravity, though, actually, so maybe it's more like it goes out into the back wall, it just goes out.
I gotcha. IR Wizard says, character corpses should be edible so they aren't a total waste.
Yeah, well...
You did say.
Yeah, this is true. We can maybe put them into compost as well. Oh my goodness.
Just heaving them into the compost?
Right, that's right. I would think that people will be quite upset about that, though.
Yeah.
All right, so I'm going to research. So here's just a kind of a taste of our research tree. What do we have here? I can't even get down there. That's funny. So I got home improvements. So that's got the storage compactor. That's got the compost. There's combustion. So there's a coal generator. So you can see how our energy is being created by just people running now.
Costs a lot of duplicate.
Yeah, exactly. So we want this, but of course it's going to have its own waste and all that. So I think I'm going to go for, I don't know.
Oh, you're switching your mind here.
I don't know. There's also food. We really want to cook our food at some point because otherwise it gets sick.
Mm-hmm. We haven't had anybody sick yet, but that's certainly possible.
Yeah. Let's do home improvement.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm just gonna do that.
I like home improvement because you kind of prepare yourself for the rest of the research. Yeah.
And then you can also build these mesh tiles, which is really good because then you can build rooms where the air flows through. Because right now the air doesn't flow through, and that can really burn you after a while.
Corner there in the bottom right next to that bed is getting pretty.
Oh, right here. Yeah. Exactly. In fact, I do need to do something about. Oh, what we got?
Oh.
Okay, so every once in a while, we print a new duplicate, basically. And we get to choose a new person that comes by.
Should we ask the stream who we should pick?
Okay.
I guess it's hard for them to read the...
Yeah, is it Catalina, Ruby, or Ellie? Which one should I choose?
Are there enemies that you need to fight, or bosses, as in don't starve, while the stream catches up?
Are there enemies? Well, there's creatures in the world. Mm-hmm. So I'm not sure I would call them enemies.
Yeah.
I would call them they're living creatures, and some of them, they, you know, they may or may not like you,
yeah.
basically.
Yeah.
You're also living there, and you're digging up their world.
Yeah, so you're all fighting kind of for the same,
yeah, exactly.
same stuff.
Boom, 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 boom.
I'm seeing a lot of Catalina.
And rubies. Not much Ellie.
Yeah.
So I think Catalina is the one.
Yeah, I think so. Thanks, everyone.
Okay, great. Let's do it.
Boom!
Dun, 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 dun!
Vince action there.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I need a new bed. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Also, they're going to start getting mad if I don't start building walls. There's some privacy in them. It's like right next to everything else, so
yeah,
they're not going to like that, too.
If somebody goes to bed and somebody walks past them, they're...
Yeah. But I'm just going to build a barracks for now. That's really what's going to happen.
You can put a little door in there.
I could put a door. Let's do it. Let's do a door. And then a tile. And let's do this. They also walk faster on tiles.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a nice little optimization. Oh, look.
Hey, hey.
Oh, algae habitat going on, emitting some oxygen and stuff.
So that's cleaning up the air.
Mm-hmm. And if I build a light here, it'll have a little bonus as well.
Ooh. I didn't know that.
Mm-hmm.
Matham is asking, how to create oxygen?
Oh, I should get some plumbing going on, actually. How to create oxygen. So currently I'm using this mineral deoxidizer, but it's quite hot and it also uses a lot of rocks and it's just not that efficient. And there's also these guys that create a little bit of oxygen. But if you research, you can do, for example, an electrolyzer, which separates the oxygen and the hydrogen from the water.
Mm-hmm.
So it'll actually also create hydrogen.
Yeah.
And then you can use that hydrogen to create more energy after that as well.
Yeah, yeah, nice.
Yeah.
No waste.
Yep.
No waste involved.
Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a little system here so that the algae habitats water themselves. Okay, so that you don't have to do it yourself.
Very nice.
So that means I'm going to create some plumbing. Okay, so I'm going to create a little, I'm going to create a plumbing here, a liquid plumber, a pumper rather, and then a vent over here.
I've never actually seen this before. I'm pretty stoked to see this.
And I want a valve. Let's build a valve up here. Here, just thinking about it here.
This is a hilariously specific question. Will you have those cool breathing apparatuses from Star Wars Episode 1, The Phantom Menace, that Qui-Gon Jinn uses to enter the Gungan underwater world? Well, will we? Hmm? Answer the guy.
They will have suits and stuff. They have equipment, actually.
There
you can
go.
Build equipment for them.
Okay. What kind of equipment are we talking here?
Like digging equipment, breathing equipment.
Nice.
So absolutely, there's that kind of thing.
Cool.
Okay. So I've planned this little contraption here. So what's going to happen is it's going to pump some water from here, and then it's going to pump the water into the valve, and the valve you can change how much water goes through, right?
Yeah.
And so we only want a little bit of water to go through, right? And then it'll go through here and drip down here, and then it'll spill through here, and the algae habitats will just suck it up automatically. And then it will fall back down.
And then if you make more algae habitats, you can open up the valve a little bit.
You can open up the valve more.
Say,
yeah,
more
exactly.
Water. Oh, cool.
Exactly. Yeah.
Automation. Wow.
Yep.
Look at that. This whole time, I've been watering my algae habitats myself like a sucker.
Like a sucker. Exactly.
I'm glad I did this stream.
All right. It also needs power, so I'm just going to...
Just as a quick reminder, this demo that we're playing right now, a time-limited version of it will be at PAX in Seattle.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow. So if you're
crazy
in the area, please go and give it a shot. Okay. They didn't build that bed yet.
That's because I didn't prioritize it. You want me to prioritize it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Catalina's gonna want to go to sleep.
Yeah.
But she's
have other jobs to do though. First, they want to eat things.
Yeah, that's
first.
True.
Like, look at this. It can cause diarrhea or dweebcephaly.
Very nice.
Indeed.
A little touch of Chris.
Yeah. That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's hope they don't get diarrhea. Actually. That would really suck.
You only have one toilet, so.
Maybe I should build another toilet.
Yeah, you got another person.
I'll deal with it later. There's so many other things to do right now. What could possibly happen?
You'll be regretting that decision, my friend, when they're all laying in bed peeing themselves.
It's just pee. It's all good.
Do some tasks lower the energy levels of the duplicants, like make them tired from dark shaders?
Not currently, but there's as we build the game up, we layer on more and more things that happen to people. Mm-hmm. So, for example, the eating causing disease is something that we recently added. So it's just something where we're slowly adding the systems. We're not trying to add too much at one go.
Yeah, makes sense.
Okay, so here we go. I should probably build another algae habitat too. How's our? Oh no, it's actually pretty
That's
good.
Not bad.
Yeah. Although it's over there.
Yeah.
That's really what's going on.
Do you ever throw one in there?
Yeah, but you can also build a gas pump mm-hmm. where it pumps the gas, it filters the gas, and yeah. it pumps it back in.
Just filter out the
yeah, just filter dioxide. Out the carbon dioxide, right?
Yeah.
So we can just do that as well. Usually, actually, what I do is I just build a mesh tile below.
Oh, and then do a row
and then
of...
I just let it pass by through here.
Yeah, yeah,
right?
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
basically
kind of like a ventilation,
a tunnel. Yeah,
but without actual
exactly,
pumping.
Exactly.
Nice. Mm-hmm. Is there any combat in this game?
Well, there are creatures, and they are not always friendly. So that's there's definitely going to be things where you have to worry about other creatures doing bad things to you. And so in that sense, there is combat. There is an attack function here. But that's not really the focus of the game. The focus of the mm-hmm. game is about, basically combat is a system in and of itself
exactly.
around this whole thing where you're trying to balance all the different systems together.
Yeah, it's kind of another way you're interacting with the stuff around you. Yeah. If a duplicant dies, this is a question from Matham again.
Okay.
If a duplicant dies, will it increase the anxiety level of the
yes,
other duplicates?
Yes, absolutely it does. And that's why we have a tasteful memorial. You can build a tasteful memorial.
Just so tasteful, man.
Yeah. And then it will somewhat decrease the amount of stress that people get.
Right.
And the problem with actually leaving a dead duplicant lying around is that they rot.
Yeah.
And then bad
more
things
disease.
Happen. More diseases, yeah. more things happen. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
I'll have a little nap there, everyone.
Yeah. Let's speed that up here. How's our report, actually? Yesterday, we really don't create enough oxygen here going on.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's not very sustainable
not very
there,
good.
Man.
Yeah. And that's because we have this, but then it's also being supplemented by these, which is not added into the report.
Oh, okay, I see.
Those aren't being added to the report because you're not generating it, right?
Gotcha, cool.
So it just kind of shows what you're doing so that you can better prepare for what happens.
What happens when those things are those things limited? What's the deal with those?
These?
Are you just going to use them forever?
They're going to run out soonish. You can see the weight of it, the mass of it decreasing rather, and so it's going to run out. And a whole bunch of them already did run out previously. You can see that it used to be used to be quite big, right?
So yeah. So this is kind of your time's counting down that you're able to rely on
these
things.
That's okay. I'm just going to let that happen for now because there's so many other things to do. Man, I hope this gets done soon because I really want to get to combustion.
Yeah, this is still home improvement that you're in. You're
I know
researching
it takes. It takes.
How
about,
good is she at researching here?
Oh, you know what?
Are you
I didn't
prioritizing
choose.
This
oh,
correctly?
I didn't choose the right person to do it. You're right. I totally
there we
did
go.
Not. All right, so there
couldn't
we go.
couldn't have written that
Thank
better.
Thank you. Yes, that's the way. There you go. Look at her learn.
Uriah was on there like, dude, I don't know what I'm doing
I don't know
on
what
here,
I
man. Like, what? This looks right, I guess.
All right. Come on, build.
Dark Shaders asks, can the duplicants... I'm seeing a lot of people write duplicates.
Okay.
It's duplicants.
Yes.
But can the duplicants have nightmares or bad dreams, which worsen their mood?
I think actually Jarrett was actually making that happen.
He
like
was,
literally
yeah.
he was working on that.
Yeah. I really
right
like
now,
that.
Yeah, right now the answer is no, but who knows
yeah.
right now. Yeah. Combustion, will people catch fire? Yes, there is going to be fire. There's no fire right now, but there is going to be fire.
What research is complete?
Oh, yes. That's what that sound is. Okay.
Ooh, that was
so I got
not
that.
How it sounds.
I got a lavatory, I got a...
Better toilet.
Better toilet.
Good thing you didn't build another toilet.
All right, I'm going to do the combustion thing and start building a toilet. But I need a place to put the waste for the toilet. Mm. I don't have a place for that. I guess I could just dig one out.
Yeah.
Just dig out a hole.
Right by their beds.
Right by their beds.
Don't want any leaks happening there.
Yeah, okay, right? let's do that. Let's just come down here. And then... Man, who made that sound?
I don't know. I saw one person say the sound design is excellent. And I'm, thanks. Thanks, buddy.
Okay.
Asteroid 7 says, I like it so far, so what's game over in this game? Are there saves so you can load them, or do you have to restart everything?
No, you can save. In fact, I'm just going to... Whoa. That
good,
felt bad.
Good thing we saved there.
That felt bad.
Let's save.
Yeah. Stream. There we go. Okay.
Clam Jam suggests just have the waste leach into their drinking water.
Oh, great.
Urine is sterile. Well, try that out when you get the game, and we'll see. You could do that, I suppose.
Come on. Build stuff. Just that. Just that left. Okay. So you can see the water that's going through here.
Oh, yeah. It's pumping.
That's this one. Yeah. You can see the water going through here. And so there's that. Now I want to change how much. 1 kg per second.
I've never seen that.
Yeah, that's okay. 1 kg per second is okay. That's a pretty good one, actually. Let's just leave it at that. Ooh, someone got their skill increased.
Tinkering.
So that's basically using things, right?
Operating machines.
Operating machinery. She's better at running on the manual generator now, basically.
Nice.
Okay, everyone go to bed.
Look at that. Disturbed sleep. Catalina woke everybody up.
Oh, yeah. I really need to create individual rooms. They're so needy.
Yeah, I know.
Those are so needy.
Jeez, man. Who made that?
Who made that happen, huh? Okay. And we need oxygen. Oh, my goodness. Okay. At least our food is good.
Yeah,
our food is good.
Nice.
Oh, our stress is not good. Our stress is going...
It's not terrible. Your average stress is only 7.
Yeah, that's
true. Still manageable.
Okay. What should I do next?
So, I don't know how to pronounce this name. I apologize. Klei?
Okay.
So how do you get more water?
Well, there's a few ways. One, you can dig for more water. So you can see water that's going around here, and you can just go explore for more water. The other way is you can recycle things. So when basically what's going on is when they're using this right now, they're turning into solid because it's going into the dirt, right? And now you're going
to
get...
Oh, yeah, because you had to put dirt into that.
That's right.
It requires you to fill it with dirt.
So instead, I can create a laboratory which... will basically change their just take water in and have dirty water come out, contaminated water come out, and then you have to purify that water in order to use it again.
Right.
Okay. So I'm going to build a
filtration
here, and then where is my pipe?
Teriyaki Dactyl says, can your duplicants grow beards? And if they do, will their productivity decrease if the beard gets too long and in the way?
Okay.
Very nice.
Okay, the water's going. Oh, somebody go empty that.
Oh, gee.
Come on.
Oh, gee.
Come on. Somebody. Hurry up.
Come on.
Oh, no. You need to. No. Don't do that.
Do you have a compost bin? What do they do if you don't have a compost?
They just dump it on the side.
Oh, boy. Very nice.
Okay, there we go.
Just like real life.
Yeah, just like real life.
They it just
goes right next to it. Sure. That's where it goes.
Perfect. Great.
I can build a compost, so I should build a compost. That's the answer. The answer is I should build a compost.
What were you going to use this little section here for?
Dump the bad water.
Oh, boy.
I was going to dump the bad water. Okay, here's... All right, here we go again. Archibald, Ada, or Bert?
I know who I like. We're going to wait and see, but I've got my pick. I hope it lines up. Benjo72 asks, what kind of game engine does this run on?
This is running in Unity, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's our first Unity game.
Yeah.
Archibald.
I see one answer, and it's Archibald. That was my choice as well, so...
Bert.
And
that bun. Bert. Oh, the bun. That's true. It's got a man bun.
Oh, yeah.
Bert.
Oh, yeah.
Bert. Okay.
It's Bert. Clear. Yeah. I had it in for Archie, but...
Yeah, it's the bun. Let's do the bun.
The bun is good.
Boom. Okay, yes. Oh, no, they're peeing themselves. Okay.
Oh, gee.
Okay, here we go. Okay, so I got a mess. Oh, and it's spilling over.
It's
okay.
Creating a little pee pit in there.
Okay, everyone. Oh. Okay, so here we go. Come on.
It's in the food, too.
No.
Your ration box is hanging out.
No. I'm cleaning it up. See,
it's
I'm
bubbling
it up. It is bubbling.
Slow it down a little bit. I don't see those bubbles.
Okay.
That's all there good. We go. Oh, it's in their beds, too.
Oh, no! Oh, someone else is peeing. That's what's going on.
The person that's researching is just chilling and just wading through some nice treats.
All right, so let's look at the oxygen view here. Now you can see this yellow.
Too hot.
What?
Sorry to interrupt there, but...
What?
We got some...
What? Oh, no.
Pee pit.
Somebody died.
Somebody died? Oh, two did. How?
They overheated.
Oh.
Okay. All right.
Who died? Maybe they're unimportant.
Uriah and Catalina. Okay, let's build some...
Well, we just got a new one, so...
This is true. All right, come on. Go away. Go away.
What kind of pee bubbles? Well, gross ones. That's the answer.
Okay, come on. Just finish doing the thing.
Ah. So close. They're all going to wake up.
And then they're all going to... Well, the two of them.
Mm-hmm.
I only have two people left?
Where's the other two? Oh, no.
I thought I had three.
Why did they overheat?
Oh, no. This person just needs to take someone else's bed.
Okay.
That's what it is. Bert.
Bert. New Bert. Okay. Bert with the bun.
There we go.
I assume they overheated because they were hanging out near that microbe musher too long.
I think there was also just a bug.
Yeah, that makes sense.
That's what it's going on.
It seems, I tried to spin a little tail.
Yeah,
there,
that's okay.
Just a bug.
Just a little bug, as it goes.
Sleeping in the pee pit. Yeah.
All right, well, they're sucking up the water.
Sound bug occurring right now too.
Oh yeah?
Oh no, maybe not. Oh.
Yeah, I'm just going to increase this water flow. What's going on right now is they're just sucking up all the little bits of water instead of going and getting the big
I see.
Bit of water. So it's actually slowing them down instead.
Right. So just getting little tiny chunks.
Yeah, exactly. So instead, actually, I'm just going to shut it off. Cool.
Question, are there rare materials or equipments from Brisley?
Yes. Well, there is basically harder and harder materials to make, and you have to go out and get the... you have to go and get the resources to do so.
Yeah.
And to do that, you have to go out and explore the asteroid.
I gotcha.
I'm just going to mop that up because it's just slowing them down right now.
I figured out what that bug was. It's that rock that's repeatedly banging Catalina in the face. Being dead is
Why
not enough.
Why do you need a toilet? There's a toilet right there. Why don't you go use it? Why is she not using the toilet?
Linus, come on.
And she's just idle, just not going to the toilet?
Is it
because there's this guy?
Is there dirt in the toilet? Have they already...
No, it's totally usable.
Out of order.
Out of order. Oh, why is it out of order? Oh, it's awaiting dirt. Why isn't anyone giving it dirt? Everyone's busy, that's why.
Yeah, I see. Too busy having to pee to go and make
okay,
the toilet usable.
I'm going to get rid of that. Just deconstructing that right now. Okay, fine. There we go.
Oh. Oh, yeah. Nice.
Okay, I did it.
There we go.
I did it.
Merrick Blaha Art asks, what's the program you animate with? They use Flash.
Flash. That's right. These bugs have totally...
Things have gone sour here.
Yeah, not great.
Dexter's Comic Laboratory says, oh man, poor Catalina, that's just crushing to watch.
Yeah.
Nice pun.
Okay, why is Linus not doing anything? Did Linus... Oh, I told her not to do anything but research.
Mm-hmm.
That's what's going on here. And Bert doesn't show up, right? Okay.
Oh yeah, I see. Rest in not so peace, Catalina, yeah.
Okay, here we go.
So we got Bert building some,
Oh no, this person's really mad! Linus is really mad. She's gonna start breaking stuff.
Was she the destructive one?
She's probably destructive. Let me take a look at stats. She's destructive.
Yeah, okay, nice.
Yeah, she's gonna start breaking stuff.
What's she mad about? Can we solve that here?
I gotta see, look. She is... she's hot. Yeah. She's got a bed, but her food quality is poor. She doesn't have a mess station. We can build her a mess station. That could help. Okay, let's build her a mess station here. Where do I build her? Next to the toilets? Should I build her a mess station next to the toilets?
Let's map out where the least likely spot for them to pee everywhere is.
I think it's going to be right here, basically.
Seems safe.
And I'm going to need to build some of that and also that. Okay, go.
Benjo72 asks, can duplicants die of too much stress?
They do not die. They kind of freak out. And different people freak out in different ways. And so, for example, Linus... goes in. Bert just brought Uriah to bed.
I need this corpse.
Oh my goodness.
All right, weird.
That's awkward.
That's weird.
That's really awkward.
You guys made a mistake inviting Bert into this corner. I'll just say that. Just say that.
Yeah. So Linus breaks stuff, but other people might just kind of like go in a fetal position, whatever. Yeah. Oh, there we go. See?
Oh.
That's what. Bert was,
Linus was so dedicated to that job that she didn't want to stop while taking a nap.
Okay, come on. Let's keep going.
Or that was
you know what? Rather. I don't need any of this stuff. I don't need that.
What was all that for?
That was for the piping for the toilet that I'm not going to use now because I have other problems to worry about, like a compost. I need a compost.
Ooh, it's getting gross over there.
It is getting gross
over
there.
Look at that air. Oh, it's bubbling.
Yes.
I need she's going angry there.
Where? Oh no, that's our oxygen.
That's the thing you don't want them to break, is the oxygen machine.
She'll repair that.
Her stress was too high there, so she just vented by destroying the oxygen machine.
Yeah, that's very smart of her.
Yeah, that's when you have a bunch of people.
No, stop.
Oh, and the power. Looking good there, Linus.
I'm good at this game. Yeah. Oh, and she's repairing it. She broke it, and now she's like, okay. Oh, no!
What can you do about
some other things? Well,
just let her run havoc?
You can pacify them. You can basically knock them out and stuff. But that doesn't really work right now.
Fair enough.
It's okay. We'll just fix it.
Linus reigns supreme here.
Okay.
Gnome says, the problem with her life was too much oxygen, so she solved it.
So she solved it.
Common problem.
Okay, and we also, I'm just going to build a, build some walls, she'll be a bit happier.
Mm-hmm.
It's more private.
Yeah.
Okay, there's the compost going. Oh, she needs the bathroom.
Oh, she's over there changing the compost out there.
Oh.
Catalina is still being destroyed.
Tasers. We need to add tasers. That's right.
To use against Bert for being a weirdo.
Is oxygen included?
Very nice.
Nope.
Put her in jail. Oh. Habdome Raider says, what are their little electricity guns?
It's called a multi-tool. It basically lets them do all sorts of miscellaneous things, and you can build new... So all the things that they're doing building and digging and picking up and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And then you can build them new ones, basically. You can build them better ones. Yeah. So if you look at the equipment, there's a crafting station that can build new multi-tools.
Yeah, nice.
Mm-hmm. I need more oxygen here. So I'm gonna build one right in the middle.
Oh, nice!
That's how I'll do it. So they can go and breathe easier. They can breathe easier, eh?
Breathe easy while sleeping. A couple questions. When can we play this?
Once it goes into early access, which it's probably a few months away still. We're just working through. Making sure that it's good enough for everybody. As you can see, there's still some bugs and going on in the game and all that, and there's still a lot to make.
Yeah.
But we love showing this stuff that's work in progress.
Yeah, I'm pretty stoked to be showing this.
Yeah.
The other answer to that question is at PAX. If you're at PAX this weekend, we've got a setup there that you can go and try the game out.
Mm-hmm.
Michi01 asks, who created the duplicants and sent them there?
Soon Linus is going to be uncreated because she keeps breaking our stuff. But beyond that, you're gonna learn more about the, the history of the duplicants as you play the game.
Mm-hmm.
So we're not really revealing that right now. But what is true is that we keep printing new ones as time goes on. That's what's going on. So you can see that
230 seconds.
There's another 230 seconds for the next one to come in.
And guess what? You just had someone die.
Are you kidding?
I think you got the message there. Oh, Bert. Well, it serves you right, Bert.
Groan. Need another tasteful memorial that they're not building.
Somebody did ask, why can't you just slow the game down if you're getting overwhelmed? Which you could.
I could.
But
this is more fun, right?
Yeah. It's fun to just be on a train that's
escaping
the station terrifyingly
fast. And then this is like slow.
From a sound perspective, I like slowing it down sometimes because the sounds are a little bit different when you're in slow speed. Mathem99 asks, is the world unlimited or does the world end somewhere and you're unable to go further?
The world does end. It's not unlimited, but it is huge. Mm-hmm. It is big enough where, I've never been able to play to the end of it. Yeah. So, and as you go out, there's more and more.
There's all this weird stuff.
All this other biomes and things.
Slime.
I wish I could show the gas. Actually, you know what? We're nearing the end here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show some fun things.
Yeah.
So I'm going to turn this on, and that shows some of the stuff that's going on out here.
A sneak peek.
That's all I'm going to show there. We're still working on the biomes. But what this also shows is a cell painter, so we can paint different things going on. So, for example, I'll paint some ice here. So you can see that's negative 40 degrees, and you can see that in the temperature view. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to make some super hot, maybe I'll just make some steam.
Yeah.
Maybe not. I'll make
What about a building that produces heat? Will that do it?
No, I'd rather do copper. Where's copper?
Mm.
Super hot copper. I'll do molten copper here. So
that was my nickname in high school.
I can't tell if you're serious or not.
No.
All right, so here we go. Okay, hopefully this doesn't crash the game because this is super hot. So I'm going to see how it goes here.
Oh! Boy, that's some hot lava.
That's some hot lava.
I didn't make that joke. Somebody else said it.
Okay, so it's dripping down. It's melting stuff, and it is creating havoc in our base.
Jeez. Oh.
Oh, and it did crash. good times.
That was some havoc right there.
You could see what I wanted to show was as it drips down, it dripping into the water, and then the water turning to steam.
Right.
And then you could see if the steam goes up and then hits something else, it will cool down and turn back into water.
Okay.
Right? So I wanted to show that.
And you could think of ways to use that.
Yeah, exactly.
Help your base out.
Where is the game here?
Dun, dun, dun. Oxygen knot.
Right here?
Yeah, and then build.
Is this the one?
Yeah. Let's hope that it connects to the capture screen.
Maybe?
Hey.
Ooh, look at that.
There we go. Very nice, very nice.
Maybe I can still show some of that. Full of science, Wade says.
Absolutely.
Okay, here we go. Space events, yes. So the world is moving through space, and so we do intend to have different events happen in the world. Okay, let's try this. I'm gonna paint some ice first, and then I'm gonna melt it. And maybe it'll crash, and maybe it won't. Oh, the sand also falls by itself, so that's cool. That often screws people up as they're playing.
Often I'll get somebody stuck in this little hole.
Oh, yeah.
Where they can't breathe, and they're just entombed in
that
sand.
That sucks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then you prioritize everybody else to go and dig them out.
Dig them out? Yeah, that's right. All right, so maybe I'll do just water, just really hot water instead. Maybe that's what I'll do, and melt it. So 90? No, wait.
90K. Did Elliot make this tool?
Okay, so 270.
Just let me do some math.
360. Let's do that.
Nice.
Let's do that. Okay. God.
Oh, they're going to get.
Okay.
Soundango asks, what will this be shipping?
See, look, you can see it warming up. You can see that warming up, right? Okay.
Here we go. We're reaching zero here, baby.
And
oh, I'm melting.
It's melting. It's melting. There you go. It melts.
Nice.
Right? And then if I make 400. Oh, yeah. I'm sorry. You're super hot and can't breathe.
Let me just boil these people alive.
I wonder why. Did I do that?
Yeah. I don't know, man.
Okay. That's steam. I created some steam here. And it should cool down from touching the dirt. Maybe if I make some ice first up here. Oh, actually, I can just make some ice by doing 250 Kelvin. Let's do some ice up here. There we go. See? And then the...
you made that by just creating water.
Yeah, I just created some ice up there. I created some ice up here. And then it's not melting. What's actually... Well, it's also melting a little bit by a little bit. But what's also happening is the steam is turning back into water.
I see.
What's happening going on there.
Crazy.
Yeah.
Your duplicates are like, what is happening
is going on? Oh, somebody died there. They're trying to avoid the death.
Real hot.
Yeah.
Steamy. I don't like this.
There you go. All right. So that is our game, I think.
Yeah.
I think we're about done.
We got about 5 minutes. Let's. You want to field any remaining questions?
Yeah, sure.
Exist.
Any questions going on? Can I change the temperature to Celsius? Yeah, actually, the temperature is in Celsius right now. And you can also change it to Fahrenheit or Kelvin.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Can you make a turbine?
Currently, no. There's no turbine. They can't swim. That's true. They cannot swim right now. Anything else?
There's some weird questions in there. How did you come up with the idea for this game?
So I think it was basically Alia and Julian and Yogi, they came together and they were just brainstorming a game that they wanted to make, and they just wanted to make a super nerdy game. And off they went, so I think that's how it goes.
Here we are.
Yeah. So super fun.
Nice. Happy birthday, Dark Shader's friend Simon. Can you customize your people?
You can rename them. We haven't thought too much more about that. They're all different, of course, as you saw. You can equip them with different things. Can you create your own? That's a question that we don't really know right now.
Nice. Mm-hmm. Can you explore the entire asteroid and the edge of the map? Or is the edge of the map the end of the asteroid?
It's basically just the edge of the map.
Okay. Can you culture water creatures, such as alien fish, for food?
So yes, you can definitely go use the aliens for whatever they are. That might be food, that might be other things. All the aliens do their own thing, and then you can harness that however you want.
Right, mm-hmm. Nice. What is game over in this game?
Game over is all your dupes die, basically.
Cool.
Mm-hmm.
Sweet.
Release date console. We don't have a release date right now, and we don't really know what the console for what other platforms. We're concentrating on PC and Mac right now. There we go.
Cool.
I think that's it, right?
Yeah.
Thanks, folks. Jamie.
Yeah, thanks, Jamie.
Boom.
We enjoy it too much, I think. But we're
right.
The only ones.
We're the only ones who. Yeah, that's right.
Even people around the office, when we do this,
they're like,
okay, cool, guys. Yeah, we get it. It's same cool. Names, very nice.
I wonder if the load would work. I don't want to touch anything.
You were looking at loading back.
Loading back the other one. But anyway, it doesn't really matter.
Cool.
Okay, thanks very much, everyone. Thanks for tuning in.
Get into exit mode here. Cam only. Thanks for streaming, Jamie. Thanks for watching the stream. Reminder, you can play this at PAX tomorrow. I'm not sure what the booth number is, but it's in there somewhere. So if
it's
you're in the
near
area,
the Indie Mega booth.
Sweet. If you're in the area, go check out PAX.
Yep.
Awesome. Thanks for watching.
Thanks very much.
And see ya. What a countdown. And then